Orpheum and State Theaters in Minneapolis, they're also celebrating a birthday.
Yeah, they're celebrating 90 years. You know, they've hosted some of the biggest names in music and in theater. But
Marx Brothers been there.
Oh, that's cool.
Jack Benny's been there.
You have a whole
George
long
list. George Burns has been there.
Unbelievable. John knows a lot, but there's a lot we might not know about the theaters. Emily Engberg is going to help us check into some of the history.
When you're celebrating 90 years, you've got to throw a big party, and that's exactly what's happening at the State and Orpheum Theaters on Saturday.
We're going to have vaudeville acts, so we're going to really show sort of what it was like in 1921 to have those acts around, and also just a chance to explore the theaters, to look at the artwork, to really absorb the beautifulness and the richness and the gilt of these gilded palaces.
Over the past 9 decades, both theaters have undergone some big changes, and David Marietta has been around for a lot of them.
When I got to be 15 and 16 years old, I would start going to work with my father in case somebody didn't show up. And that's how I got my start.
So what kind of things were you doing when somebody wouldn't show up?
Oh, I would be a prop person.
David doesn't just work for the Orpheum Theater, it's in his blood.
Yes, I had two vaudeville performers in the family, and that's how they all started with him. And then my grandmother was a wardrobe, and she ran the union, and my grandfather was a carpenter at the Minnesota Theater.
In fact, go through the old pictures and you're bound to find several of his family members. David also plays a big role in the theater's history.
What are these? They have names on them, but are they cue cards or what are they?
These are all vaudeville acts from the 30s and 40s. And there's an annunciator on both sides of the proscenium. And it's all automated, it's all original equipment. And what it would do was pick up one of those cards, and the lights would flash, and it would transfer one card to the next. So that replaced the gal that used to walk across the stage with showing the next act.
David has made some pretty incredible discoveries over the years.
I find things. In the ceilings, I've found things. When theaters closed down, I would go get spotlights and stuff out of them, things that they were going to throw away. So I have a museum, we call it down there, which looks like piles of junk, kind of, but.
This is what David refers to as the museum. Several interesting items, including an old ticket machine, old artwork, and of course, something he found in a ceiling.
So I had to get up above a ceiling to fix a leaky pipe in the 70s, and I found this, and this was part of the vaudeville troops that used to come through this theater.
You can see some of these pieces during special theater tours.
We're so fortunate to have some of these. These are posters from some of the shows that stayed here. This is a gong from Miss Saigon. When the theater was renovated, the gong broke while it was here, and so now it's here in our museum. If you look up here, there's a record album. Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan and his brother owned this theater for a few years.
The museum is always a work in progress. After all, David is still making discoveries. Discoveries that will hopefully be around to share for the next birthday celebration in 90 years.